Hi, I'm Scarlett.
And I'm Shotzi.
And welcome to our Chamber of Horrors!
Show us anything that happened in this house. Show us something about Sarah Winchester. You see that? Something just crawled up there?
Killed?
Oh,
it was
no,
killed.
It came
was
up
killed.
Twice. Like,
it was
I turned
killed.
It on yes. here and it yes. went on.
Do you hear a devil?
I think Clyde touched me again. I can't wait to get home. Yeah.
We are in San Jose, California at the Winchester Mystery House. And this place holds a special place in my heart because I am from here. I was born right down the street. I grew up right down the street.
That's how you do it, idiots.
Oh!
Yeah,
no, that was
this is my
really
hometown.
Good.
Yeah, it was good.
Well, it's also my hometown.
Well, it's my hometown, all right? I'm older
yeah,
than you.
Do you have a bottle of warm
salt? In my fridge.
Okay, yeah. All right, fair, yeah. fair.
No ghosts in my house.
How do you feel about ghosts, Bayley?
I don't like it.
Have you ever had an experience with a ghost?
Yeah, actually I have. First of all, I grew up hearing stories. But I did have a really weird experience. Do people really say their experiences or do they just?
Every time.
Yes, please.
Yes.
Yeah.
that's on a little, anyways.
Every time.
It was NXT UK tour and I was in Liverpool, Robbie Brookside's hometown. We were at the hotel. They told me that place was haunted and I believe in ghosts. I believe in the spirits. I believe in it all. And I just went along with them because I was bored and it was late at night. And this guy was showing us, the guy that worked at the hotel was showing us all over, telling us what apparently there were murders with children stuff and families and all these really weird, scary, sad stories. So he showed us around. He's like, this happened in this room, this happened in this room. And then took us to the children's playroom. And it got immediately like, freezing freaking cold. And I was like, I can't do it anymore. I'm gonna go to bed, guys. I'm gonna leave. They stayed out and like did whatever. The next day I went to the front desk and I was like, where's that, what's the guy's, whatever the guy's name, say his name's Randy. I was like, hey, is Randy working today? And they're like, who's Randy? And I was like, he helped us. He looks like this. They're like, there's nobody here who works.
Randy's a ghost.
So it was either a freaking ghost or they're messing with me, but I definitely felt whatever it was, whoever Randy was, I felt something in the hotel and it was creepy as hell.
Well, if you get scared, you're stuck with us tonight. You are not leaving. Once we enter those doors, you are going through a full Chamber of Horrors investigation.
Okay, well, I'm staying close to Scarlett because I don't trust you. I don't trust you, you weirdo.
But have you heard of this place? Do you know why it's so haunted and so bizarre and creepy?
First of all, you said it's not as haunted. You said it's more like a historical lesson.
Yeah, because no, I was trying to get you here.
It's very haunted. It's actually very, very haunted.
Well, my nephew brought me here a few years ago, but. Go on, tell them.
Well, Sarah Winchester of Winchester Rifle created this house because she thought she was being haunted by all of the people that died from the Winchester rifle. So she created this bizarre labyrinth of a mansion to confuse the ghosts to keep her from haunting her. So hopefully we get to see some of those ghosts and maybe Sarah Winchester will pop up.
You make it sound way creepier than like when we do the tours, they make it sound very educational. That sounds scarier.
Oh, this place is very
was
creepy.
Was that a bat?
That was a bat.
That was definitely a bat.
Freaking bats! There are staircases that lead to nowhere in this house. There are doors
that
drop off up the third floor. You can get lost in this house.
Didn't like a bunch of all her people that worked with her live with her?
Yeah, because she wanted them working on the house 24/7.
Yes, like I said, don't stop building.
Yeah, she moved here and she was working on this house until her death, which she also died here.
Yeah, I remember that. Cool. Cool.
So are you ready to ghost
hunt? Yeah, let's do it!
Let's do it!
Woohoo!
Sweating already.
Winchester Mystery House! Hi!
Hi!
Hi, I'm Olivia.
Hi, you're Shotzi.
Hi.
Scarlett.
Olivia.
Hi. Bayley, nice to meet you.
Awesome. Well,
We're gonna go through a couple of the more important rooms of the house, just so you guys know, like Sarah's bedroom, maybe the seance room. Ooh,
yes. What about the witch's hat? We've heard.
I will take you to the witch's cap. I can. That is a place where there's a lot of activity. I myself have had quite a bit happen on the third floor. Ooh. Much to be told, I can share on the way.
Oh my goodness. Wait, I would love to hear like your most scary, creepy story that you've got.
So this one actually was corroborated by three different experiences in the same day.
Oh my goodness.
Because I used to always tell people, I've heard stuff, but I've never seen anything. Because I'm in this house alone by myself. And there was one day I was down one of our longest hallways and I saw a man looking at me. Ah! And this was before hours. So I snapped into the manager mode of, you're not supposed to be in here. Went down. Everything was closed. All of the ropes were up. I was the only one in the house. And I was like, that's fine. I'm just gonna take my exit. Later that day I was taking a guest, looking down that same hallway. She's like, I don't know how to tell you this, but I'm a medium and I could see a tall man in a hat down watching us.
Top hat man.
And then I left for the day because I felt like that was enough.
Yeah.
Because it was corroborated by three people and I felt like he was saying, go home, get some rest. So I did. I took a couple of
days. Wow, I don't believe you. Well, I hope we get to meet him tonight.
Yeah, me too. And why are they always wearing funky hats?
I don't know what it is. They never in something more modern. It's always just the old school hat looking thing. Now we can go through people. The front doors if you guys are ready.
Yes, absolutely.
Let's do it. What a beautiful door.
Yeah, so pretty.
So we're in the seance room because Sarah Winchester was a very spiritual woman.
There are rumors that she was actually involved in the occult, but that was never confirmed. Some people believe that she was part of the Freemasons in the female order.
Sarah, were you an occultist?
I think she was.
Oh my. And what is that? You could sneeze?
So yeah. This is a very special VR. It uses electromagnetic frequencies and magnets to create an AI-generated image of whatever spirits want to show us. some people might think, oh, it's all gimmick, but there is absolutely no location services on. It doesn't know where we are. It showed us the actual murder of Lizzie Borden, and it also shows what the murder weapon was when we asked.
Oh my God!
What is it?
Oh,
okay, so it's like a little kid.
That was literally the remote upstairs. Like literally. Oh my gosh. It's a building.
Building.
Just a big brick, abandoned looking building.
Guys, we asked where the murder weapon is.
Would you like to do the honors? You don't want to do the honor? Do you want to do the first honors?
I don't want to. Nope.
So I feel like someone wants to talk to us.
Yeah.
So I'm pulling up our spirit talker. Scarlett, can you explain the spirit talker to Bayley?
So there are different forms of spirit boxes. There's SB7s. Hello. Yeah, I think you want to talk to the spirit box. So spirit boxes, it's a radio frequency. It scans both radio stations at the same time, extremely quick, 14 stations per second, creates a white noise. Spirits can use that energy to speak through it.
Wow.
Yes. So you can get very specific answers. It is also very polite to introduce yourself to the house before you begin speaking.
Okay. Hi, I'm Bayley.
I'm Scarlett.
I'm Shotzi. Hi. We come in peace. We come with love and light in our hearts.
Show us anything that happened in this house. Show us something about Sarah Winchester. Who was she? Oh, I got an image.
Are there any spirits here? Would you like to talk to us?
I see a clock, and it looks almost like an old gold fireplace. Take a look.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
So if we see that in the
house
later.
Not what I expected.
Oh, I missed it. Oh wait, no, I see it. Oh, interesting.
What is that?
It's very old timey. It looks like something that might be in this house.
What does that have to do with Sarah?
I don't know. Maybe it's in the house. Oh, what?
Right.
That looks closer.
No. Oh,
right which here. One?
No! It's just so, like, When do you ever see like a clock above like a fireplace?
I turned over, I realized that that was really similar because we have so many, there's 47 fireplaces in the house.
Oh, yeah.
So it was kind of anyone's best bet as to which one
right.
was being shown, but it does look an awful lot like these ones.
Can you tell us your name and why you're here?
Anna.
How many spirits are here in this room right now?
Six, seven.
Was it six?
Six.
Oh, six, yeah, six, yeah, six. Thank you, thank you.
What was that? What was that?
Do you have a message that you would like to have relayed? Yes, do you have a message? What's your message? Can you talk to me through the spirit talker? Ladies?
What
did he
say?
Ladies?
That's right.
Yeah, we are.
Let me put on my spirit talker.
How did you die? Killed?
So you're killed?
I did. Veil?
I don't hear this thing well. I'm like, them?
Killed, it was killed. It was killed, it was killed.
Oh,
it was killed.
Whoa,
it came it was up killed. Twice.
Like, it was I killed. Heard it on yes. here and it yes. went on there.
It was killed.
That's creepy.
Yes.
I love when they match up, that like really
whoa.
Like.
So this is an obelisk. Some people think, oh, it's a phone app. It doesn't work very well. I've had this thing when we've been around a mirror with a presence. Someone said that mediums started crying around this haunted mirror. We asked about the owner. We were talking about the history of it. The name Edward came up on this. I asked who the owner of the mirror was, and his name was actually Edward. So whoa. This thing has been spot on with answers to a yeah. point where it's terrifying.
What's all the like background noise on? Is that just the because of the machine or like the actual device or like around, is it?
It's radio frequency.
It's so it's, it is picking up spiritual energies in this house.
Yeah.
Yes. Could you say one of our names?
Oof. How does that work?
We make the noises.
Wow.
We make the noises.
Wow, they just answered your question.
Yeah.
If you make the noises, can you make a tapping sound or not?
I am freaking. I got chills.
I mean, we do this all the time, and even I'm like freaking out.
I got
out on
chills.
That.
To answer your question.
Thank you for answering me, because they are not doing a good job.
Yeah.
To answer your question, everything is energy. Energy is neither created nor destroyed. Since everything uses electromagnetic frequencies, when we're speaking to spirits, this uses a dictionary of 2,000 words and it uses different frequencies. So the ghosts are manipulating these frequencies to create words from that dictionary.
Okay.
Yes. Yes, you. But who is you?
Disaster.
Disaster. Do you mean the earthquake of 1906?
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
Were you in the earthquake here?
Yes.
Yes. Very clear, yes. Did you die on this property in the earthquake?
No.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Ooh. We're getting so much just from this one room.
I know.
I mean, I don't know if this is normal, but.
What room should we go to in this house?
Oh, that's a good question.
I probably had the most happen to me on this floor. One of my first times here, I was on a tour with 20 people around me and my hair went like that.
Whoa.
And the people looked at me, they're like, hey, did that just happen? I was like,
wow, that happened to someone on one of our episodes.
Who?
And we didn't notice
Dominic,
it until we saw it on video. Went, yep.
Gotta turn off all at once.
It's called the witch's cap. So if you look up, you can see that it kind of has that shape that we were talking about. And they think that because of that shape that it was more effective in producing any kind of paranormal energies. But if you stand right in the middle and start talking, it sounds like your head's in a bubble, which is really cool, and no one else can hear the echo.
Ooh. Wow.
Hello.
Whoa.
Do you guys hear it? You guys don't hear that? That's so creepy. Come here.
Hello. Oh my God. Why does it do that?
It's so fun.
It's the shape of it. But it is really cool.
Yeah, there was something up there for a second. Do you see that? Something just crawled up there? It looked like something was crawling on the ceiling. You saw that, right? So there's them.
This is gonna sound dumb, but do you guys ever encounter like animal spirits?
Yes.
Are there, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah, I had a ghost cat rub against my leg. And
Whoa.
I thought it was like super silly. I thought like my hair had touched my ankle, which is so dumb. But then right after that, the tour guide came back and he was like, oh yeah, by the way, like, look at like the ground. We have like a ghost cat here. And I was like,
wow,
no freaking way. Like, yep. I felt it rub against my leg.
That's freaking cool.
Oh, that was literally.
Dude,
just-
dude.
What?
Okay. I don't know. What? Like something touched my ankle.
Ah.
Okay. What was this room used for?
Oh my God, I see a woman and a baby.
Oh!
Woman and a baby.
Oh!
Or like a daughter. It's like a woman and her holding her daughter.
Like Sarah and...
Maybe. Well, no, it's like a three-year-old. And she's blinking. Oh, this is...
You know, the first name to come up was Anne. And her daughter's name was Annie.
She looks too old to be, because her daughter passed when she was young, right?
Yeah,
like six
yeah.
months. She looks a little bit older.
But sometimes ghost children come through older. But yeah, I do want to see.
Yeah. It's actually really a beautiful picture. And kind of moving and sad if it's her and her daughter.
Oh my God. But that kind of looks like Sarah.
Yeah.
Like she would always wear black. I don't know, that kind of looked... like her, like what she would wear all the time.
But yeah, like what this room, if what this room was used for, and it shows that image, but.
Interesting, yeah.
Did Sarah paint? Oh my God, I don't, or did she come up here and talk to her or think about her or?
Yeah, maybe. I mean, this whole house was like her grieving.
Yeah.
Like her trying to keep her mind off of the grief of her daughter and her husband.
Yeah.
That's why she kept building, to keep herself busy.
So we do have like an iconic ghost that has been seen for the past 100 years at the Winchester Mystery House. So we've kind of coined him as the wheelbarrow ghost. We don't know his name. But we call him Clyde. That's kind of what tour guides have called him through the years. So for the 100 years that Winchester Mystery House has been opened, tour guides and guests have been saying that they were seeing this gentleman with a wheelbarrow going up and down in the basement that we're about to go into.
Oh.
Clyde! Come hang out with me!
Oh my God. What? These are all real skeletons, guys.
Hello?
That's one thing they didn't tell you, they're real. And I'm not scared.
Clyde!
If Shotzi can do it, I can definitely do it.
You wanna hang out?
Wait, people go all the way back
you
here?
You wanna touch my friend Bayley?
Yeah. Gross.
Clyde?
Are we supposed to go all the way back here?
Yes.
No, you are.
Come hither.
Did she say it's all the way down here where they see him?
Yeah, she said that they see him like walking down this hall.
Down this hallway.
Yeah.
Cool.
I would like to put it through there since he's always seen walking over there. It's going off?
Yep.
Whoa.
You can come out if you want to.
Hi, Clyde. I'm Scarlett.
I'm Shotzi.
Hi, I'm Bayley, Clyde. Nice to meet you.
We
You scared him away.
Is it, what else is down here? Does it go down pretty far?
Yeah, I mean, it goes to where, like...
And then Clyde touched me again. My back.
Clyde, are you here? I'm here.
Clyde, are you touching my back?
Did you feel something?
Yeah.
Clyde, would you mind coming out and saying hi to us? We'd love to meet you. Did you work on the house? Oh, okay, that's a thing.
Something was just on, was just behind Bailey. Do you see it? Do you see it? Do you see it? Do you see it on camera? What is that?
Do you want to hold my hand?
Do you see that? There was something standing right there behind you. You see that?
I can't, no, I don't even know what I'm looking for though.
Can you hold my hand? Sure.
Shotzi, keep doing that. Something is debating if it wants to touch you or not.
I'm nice, I promise. I come in peace.
That thing doesn't look very human-shaped.
No.
Can you touch my hand?
It looks like it's on all fours, standing in front of you.
Are you a dog? Can I pet you?
It's trying to get away from you now.
No, it's okay.
It just ran off.
Oh.
It's a dog.
It's a dog. The ghost animals love you. Look, 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 see that? What is that? What is that? It's behind Shotzi. Hi, Clyde.
He looks like he's dancing.
Shotzi, can you come here? Do you want to see? Look. Oh, we lost him. We lost him, damn it. We saw that. It looked like he was dancing behind you. Wait,
oh, he's here. You are the same.
Clyde? Would you like to come say hi?
We want to be your friend.
Yeah, I feel like we'd get along.
In 1923, the house was bought after she passed away. And when it was purchased, so all the furniture in the house was actually removed.
Am I really dead?
Yes.
Yes, you are.
Yes, you are.
The people that purchased the home, they were looking in the beautiful grand ballroom and they saw this door that was locked. Couldn't get opened, took a few weeks to finally crack it open. Finally got it unlocked. When they unlocked it, they saw this ginormous fireproof safe.
What
like
the?
Industrial size safe in the grand ballroom of the house. They're like, oh my gosh, what is this? Took a few months, finally got it opened.
What's behind door number two?
Another safe!
Oh my
So obviously at this point, they're freaking out because they're like, what could be behind the safe? Like. Just think of all the things that it could be. Sarah Winchester was the richest woman.
Jewels, rubies and jewels.
Just even anything else. Maybe it could be old wine or I don't know, something. And so this was also locked. Finally got this opened.
Another safe.
There's 18 safes.
Wait, can I say it?
Okay, yeah, you wanna know what it's inside of it?
Yeah.
Okay, so there was three things inside of it that she
I know for sure one of them.
Okay.
A lock of her daughter's hair.
Yes.
Which I think is the sweetest, and I think that's why I remember it.
Yeah, so a lock of her daughter's hair, the obituary of her daughter, and the obituary of her husband. So there's only those three items in the safe. So I like to think of it as kind of like a Sarah had all the money in the world.
Yeah.
But
and that's what was
the
most
only important. Things that were actually important to her.
Yeah.
So super kind of gives me chills.
I know. She's the cutest.
But crazy. Yeah, so I think that was
they did spells.
They did spells.
They did
spells.
We knew it
finally. Thank you for telling us. Thank you. Did you hear a devil?
Oh, I heard it again.
You heard that?
Yes. I said devil twice.
Get me out of here. Get me out. I would freak the hell. I need more people around me, but I'm still way more interested now than I was before doing this. So.
Into ghosts and stuff?
Not into it, just like, it's just interesting to watch you guys do all of that and to communicate and to see what they're saying and what, you know, they
seem
funny.
Are you even more of a believer now?
I mean, I already pretty much was, but I guess I've never tried to interact before because I'm too scared.
Some of the conversations are kind of like spot on, huh? It's kind of weird.
Yeah.
Do you guys feel like you're gonna patch up your differences now?
No, mm-mm. If anything, I dislike her more now.
That makes sense.
That sucks because we're like hometown girls, you know? We should be friends, but she's... I can't wait to get home. Yeah.
So Bayley.
Bayley, Bayley, Bayley.
What'd you think? What I think it was, I learned a lot. And like I said earlier, I think I'm a little more interested in the tools and the equipment. I'm not interested like I want to do it, but it is a very eye-opening. I never try to communicate with, you know, spirits or anything, so. I was a little freaked out a few times, but whatever, it's fine.
What freaked you out the most?
I think just all the voices and everything, just hearing everybody try to talk and try to figure out like, and what would pop up on your phone or whatever?
The spirit talker.
Yeah, the spirit talker, what would pop up on there? It like was mind-boggling how much they're trying to communicate and talk, and like we're willing to.
Yeah.
That's insane.
Was there a favorite tool?
I really like the beeping one.
Oh yeah, me too. REM pod's my favorite.
I really like that one. Just because that to me is so real. Mm-hmm. Like it more than just like, because you can't really understand all the words coming out when they're trying to talk through that one device, but that is just like energy based, like you said, right? And I was like, woohoo.
And you've seen it not go off or do anything.
Yeah. And they were funny here. I feel like they had a good time with us.
Yeah, all the spirits here really seem to like that they are staying here.
Yeah, well, you hear about Sarah Winchester. I mean, who wouldn't want to be here?
That's
the coolest place. She like apparently took good care of them.
Sarah's the best.
Yeah.
So in honor of Sarah, should we all take a shot of sauce?
Dude, I'm
to
down.
Close out the night.
Yes!
Sauce. Close out our Chamber of Horrors.
Hell yeah.
This is my first time having the sauce.
Yeah,
oh,
it's gonna change your
goodness.
Life.
Oh my goodness.
Before, if you drive to the show tonight, you're gonna wanna stop at La Vix first.
Oh yeah, you have to. Okay.
It's a good party
for
night.
Sarah.
For Sarah.
Mm. I have my Invisalign on too. This
to Sarah.
Great.
Oh my goodness. Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness.
Sarah.
Oh my gosh, it's so good.
You like it? Yeah, Bayley went hard on that. I saw that pour.
La Vix.
So garlicky.
So good. It's good on anything.
Seriously.
Thank you so much for joining us on Chamber of Horrors.
Happy Halloween!
Oh.
Hey, that's my orange sauce, you little...